Hi, I'm Rachel Davis with ABC's Concierge Program, and I'm here to tell you how much wine you will need for your party. Definitely do not get hung up on the brand that you are serving. Your aunt may have their favorite, your best friend. However, most people do find their new favorite wines at big events. ABC actually sells a lot of exclusive brands to them, our sourced and certified products that are very great bang for your buck. I've had many people come back and say that they love the selections that they had never heard of them before. This is one of our sourced and certified wines. It is Octopoda. It's a Cab Franc. It's actually from North Coast, California. It's amazing. Your guests will be lured in by the label, but then the taste is gonna be what hooks them. All right, so for types of wines that you want to get, it definitely depends on the season, the climate. As far as Florida goes, it's hot a lot of the times. Summer season, the white wines tend to be very, very popular, light, refreshing. Sangria is a great summer option for red wine. Rosé is very, very trendy right now. In the winter time, reds are definitely going to be a great go-to. In a large bottle, you're gonna get about 8 to 9 glasses of wine, depending on how full you're filling the glasses. And then this bottle, you're gonna get 4 to 5 glasses per bottle. Champagne is a little bit of a different story. So because champagne flutes are smaller, you're gonna get about 6 to 7 servings per bottle on champagne. Now, depending on how heavy your shots are gonna be that you're pouring, you're gonna get about 40 drinks if you're doing 1.5 ounce shots and 16 drinks if you're doing 1.5 ounce shots with this one. Definitely more cost effective to go the large bottles, so this will definitely save you some money in the long run. Now that you have the basics, how much wine do you need per person, the quantities? But first, make sure you like, subscribe, hit that notification bell if you like this video. So for quantities that you are going to need, we recommend the first hour to have 2 drinks per person for that first hour. After that, it's gonna be on average about 1 drink per hour per guest. Do not be afraid of screw-off caps on wine. It makes it easy for large events to serve them. That way you just screw them off and go. You don't have to worry about pulling out the cork. What that means when it's a screw-off cap, it does not mean it is a bad quality. All it means, it is not meant to be aged for a long period of time. You're not meant to lay it down in a wine rack and, you know, turn it every few years. It means it is good to go now. Just pop the top and drink it. Know your guests at your party. If it is going to be a younger crowd, the seltzers, very hot right now. Plan on having some sweeter wines there for the intro wine drinkers that aren't used to drier stuff. More mature crowds tend to like Chardonnays, a drier type of reds. I would honestly recommend simplicity as far as your event goes. Maybe one type of red, one type of white, and maybe something such as a sparkling wine, a Prosecco. Or if you want a little bit more complexity, I would recommend maybe 2 different types of whites. What I mean by that is having something mellow, easy to drink, maybe a little sweetness to it, like a Riesling, and then maybe a Chardonnay or Pinot Grigio or Sauvignon Blanc. So you've got 2 different ends of the spectrum there for your guests. All right, well, now that you've got the basics of kind of what wines to get for your event, feel free to contact us at the concierge service, and we'll be happy to help you pick out what you need for your event.